First of all, excuse me for my voice. I've been excavating until the last week in the Abric Romani, and I get a cold, and I don't know if I will try to do my best. I want to thank the organization, Vincent, Derrinya, and Xavier Mangado for letting us participate in this session. This presentation is based on a PhD that defended in 2016 and has the aim to define the mobility patterns and the foraging radius through the lithic procurement of the Neanderthals that occupy the Abric Romani rock shelter. With this objective, we have first to try to define the characteristics of the lithic procurement of the Neanderthals who occupy the Abric Romani in level M, sublevel OA, and level P, through the Chert analysis as the main raw material used in the Abric Romani. Then, to determine the geographic origin of the Chert procurement, and in consequence, define, according to Binford, the mobility patterns and its foraging radius. The Abric Romani is a rock shelter located at the northeast of the Iberian Peninsula, in the town of Capellades, at 15 kilometers at the northwest from the city of Barcelona. It opens in a travertinic formation named Cinglera del Capelló that puts in contact the inner part of the Catalonian region with the littoral coast through three geomorphological units, the Ebro Basin, the prelitoral range, and the prelitoral basin. The Abric Romani has approximately a 50-meter succession covering from 110 to 40 kilo ESPP. The studied levels are located in the middle final section of the known sequence and are dated around 50 and 55,000 calibrate years. From a paleoclimatic perspective, five climatic phases have been documented between warm periods and cooler and drier periods, with the predominance of pine forest. If we focus on the archaeological lithic record, Chert is the most used raw material along the sequence. The other materials, which appears in all the levels, are limestone and quartz, always from a local origin, followed by slates that are not always present in the archaeological record. Only in levels H, I, and K, the presence of chert is lower than 70%, and it's always associated to the increase of quartz and limestone. Quartz mainly for levels I and K, and limestone for level H. Regarding the faunal assemblages, a dominance of Cervus elaphus and Equus ferus, followed by Bos primigenius and Rubicapra pirenaica, have been described along the sequence. A high level of bone fragmentation and high number of burned bones with rare carnivore activities and with identification of all the stages of carcass exploitation have been documented. The skeletal profiles of the ungulates indicate that the Neanderthals developed different strategies for transporting the animals from the kill site to the campsite. Among other variables, the number of possible porters was probably high, indicating a strong cooperation between the different members of the group. The site shows a characteristic high preservation of wood remains due to the formation of travertine and the sedimentological conditions. We found a negative of non-carbonized woods and positive and negative of carbonized woods. In relation to the combustion structures, we have documented more than 200 hearth along all the sequence. Regarding to the level studies for this work, the first level M is dated between 52 and 55,000 years ago. For the lithic industry, chert is the dominant material with the 80%. The objects resulting from the exploitation sequence prevail in the record. The knifing method is the discoidal, and we have localized 120 refrits, grouping 803 objects. Sublevel OA is an archaeolevel within level O. It has a surface of 200 meters squares and is dated around 54,000 calibrate years. The lithic industry consists in 1,486 objects, also with chert as the main raw material representing the 90%. The level O method is the knifing method used in this level. The last example, level P, have a surface of 247 meters squares and it's dated around 55 kilo ESBP. Chert is the dominant raw material with the 89%. The objects resulting from the reduction sequence are predominant, highlighting the high incidence of plates, which does not correspond to the kind of cost documented. There is a great variability of reduction sequence with the predominance of Levallois method followed by discoidal and others. We have structured the geological context of the silifications in function of the three geomorphological units that compose the Abric Romani environment: the Ebro Basin, the prelitoral range, and the prelitoral basin. The Ebro Basin contributes with a large amount of chert to the region. Two marginal basins form our study zone, the Gaià Basin and the Anoia Basin, mainly filled by Eocene and Oligocene materials. The second geomorphological unit is the prelitoral range, where the silifications are located in the marine carbonate deposits of the muschelkalk, in specific in the Nisian layers of lower muschelkalk and Ladinian layers of upper muschelkalk. The last one is the prelitoral basin, in specific the Panadella basin. Chert is localized in the Guixera series formed by Pliocene alluvial deposits due to the dispersive system of the Eocene formation of the Ebro basin. With the idea of defining the territorial mobility of the Neanderthals of the Abric Romani, the foraging model has been used as an ethnological framework. Within this model, an important element is the foraging radius, therefore the displacement that can be done in a single day between the best game and the location, or in this case, the place of procurement. Through multiple ethnographic studies, Binford, among others, established the foraging radius in about 8 kilometers that we rounded to 10 kilometers, and we use it with the intention of establishing the silicious expected abundance in the territory. This led us to estimate a specific foraging radius for each archaeological assemblages, through which we can infer the patterns of mobility and their directionality. Following Binford, we have three main types of mobility patterns: half-radius continuous patterns, complete radius leapfrog pattern, and point-to-point patterns. The first two are considered as a high mobile foraging due to a high biomass environment, while the point-to-point is much common in lower biomass settings, a kind of mobility pattern that not corresponds to the Abric Romani, as we know by the paleoecological and paleoenvironmental data. The difference between the first two is the development or not of a logistical foraging. For a better approximation to the territory, we have created a methodology for calculating the chert abundance ratio, meaning a prior and objective approximation of the chert availability in the landscape. These data are obtained through a series of measurements. The first one is the outcrop exposed thickness that corresponds to the lineal distance between the top and the base outcrop observed during the fieldworks. The total exposed volume is the outcropping volume of the geological formation attending to the exposed chert-bearing rocks observed in each outcrop. And the outcrop real thickness is the maximum dimension of the geological layer containing the silifications. With these measurements, we calculate the chert abundance ratio through the occurrence index and the chert content. During the prospections, we located more than 30 chert outcrops in a 30 km radius from the Abric Romani, located mainly at the northwest, west, and south of the site. If we group the chert outcrops by geographical provenance, petrographic characteristics, and archaeological representation, four geographical chert sources are described. We divide them between local and regional ones: La Serra Chert, where the main outcrops are located between 4 and 6 kilometers from the Abric Romani; Muschelkalk Chert, where the principal outcrop is located at 7 kilometers from the site; Sant Martí de Tous Chert, where the principal outcrop are located between 15 and 18 kilometers from the rock shelter; and the Panadella Chert at 24 kilometers from the Abric Romani. For the other three geographical provenance, Mediona Chert, Can Salvet Chert, and Cal Alemany Chert, no archaeological representation has been documented. For level M, we analyzed the 56% of the chert assemblages, discarded the alterate and patinate material. The Sant Martí de Tous Chert type is the most represented within 93% of the total chert analyzed, showing a procurement radius about 15 km from the site, and a unidirectional mobility northwest-southeast. In consequence, the mobility pattern is based in a half-radius continuous pattern or a complete radius leapfrog pattern. For sublevel OA, we analyzed the 26% of the Chert record, discarding the rest of material because of its alteration and patination. In the same way, the Sant Martí de Tous type Chert is the more represented with the 84% of the total Chert analyzed. Although the Panadella Chert increases present upon the 12%, showing a usual procurement radius of 15 km and an unidirectional mobility. Those aspects confirm us the primary position procurement in the regional abundant sources. Accordingly, sublevel OA has the same lithic procurement strategy that in level M. Level P is the one who has more difference, because for the first time in the Abric Romani sequence, the Panadella Chert type has almost the 50% of the total Chert representation. That means that in level P, the procurement radius is between 15 and 24 km, much more than in other levels. Also, by its killer unidirectionality and its distance of procurement, we can define not only its foraging radius, but also its logistical radius, as long as we understand the Abric Romani as a base camp in the economic zonation. As defined by Binford, that means a complete radius leapfrog pattern mobility. If we take into account the Chert abundant radius in the landscape and the raw materials represented in the archaeological record, in a 10 km radius, the most abundant raw material is the Serra Chert. For the regional radius, the most abundant type of Chert is the Sant Martí de Tous one, followed by Can Salvet and Muxical Chert, being the Panadella type almost insignificant in the landscape. The archaeological record shows a predominance in the three levels of the Sant Martí de Tous Chert type, like I told you, being the local Chert almost inexistent. Assessing the procurement is performed in the silicious most abundant sources, within the regional radius, and with a clear unidirectionality northwest-southeast. In level P, we have similar values for the Sant Martí de Tous Chert and the Panadella Chert, showing an increase in the Chert procurement distance upon to 24 km, aspect that can be explained by a change in the economic zonation described by Binford. If we look at the type of corticality presented in the archaeological assemblage, the rounded and angular shapes that could mark a fluvial, colluvial, or primary-subprimary region reach values between 40 and 60% in all the levels, being inconsistent from a statistical point of view. If we also take into account the main river course, the Anoia River, that has future, both in their current channel and in the terrains associated with the occupation of the Abric Romani levels, all this data make us to take into consideration these values. In consequence, our problematical is which dimension has the local procurement in a regional frame. That's why we understand the primary outcrop and its dispersive and a single one. Another question is what does the different type of corticality give us? There are some methods who try to answer this question, like the evolutionary chain of Chert described by Fernandez and others, but we decide to use the CAR method as a useful method to associate the archaeological record to its potential outcrops. As conclusions, we remark that the CAR method seems a useful method to define the Chert provenance. That the underrepresentation of local material show a procurement in the regional abundant sources, Sant Martí de Tous and Panadella regions. The lithic procurement radius for level M and OA is about 15 km, even more for level P that increase up to 24 km. This regional mobility range increased the non-foraging area extent of historical hunter-gatherers. The lithic procurement shows very clear heading patterns, all unidirectional from northwest with a southerly origin that can be explained by its high mobility due to a high biomass environments based in a half-radius continuous pattern for level M and OA and a complete radius leapfrog pattern for level P. For all three levels, the Sant Martí de Tous Chert type show us the foraging radius, as in level P, the high presence of the Panadella Chert type could signal us the logistical radius. Consequently, we can establish that the economic zonation for the Abric Romani is based on the ratio of the foraging radius upon the 15 km established by the outcrop locations of the Sant Martí de Tous Chert type. Thank you for your attention.